The very first time that I ever found New Bern Civic Theater, I was supposed to be here for an audition, and I was living in Havelock at the time. I was driving down Pollock and trying to find the address on the building, and I couldn't find it, but did take notice of this beautiful artistic building that I was driving by and said, oh, what a pretty building, and drove right past it after admiring it, not realizing that that was where I was indeed supposed to be. So I did a U-turn, came back around. So I walked in and I was very nervous because I'd never auditioned before, but something about this building when I walked in calmed me down. It just felt like I was coming home. And I remember walking into the auditorium and seeing the stage for the first time, and the excitement of the possibility of being on that stage was pretty cool.
It's a great vibe to the building. It's got that old mystique to it, but it had a lot of issues, a lot of problems.
Someone told me that it was progressive eclectic. Didn't know what that was, but I said, if there's an opportunity for us to do something at some point in time, we would like to do that.
First, it's a building of this age, and that creates issues in and of itself with degrading materials, as they found out doing the facade. Masonry doesn't stand up well over time if it gets wet, so that can cause some problems. Electrical has changed significantly over the last 100 plus years. When this building was built, electricity in buildings was in its infancy. So you've got a whole new system that wasn't available in buildings at the time. It's certainly how it's developed over the last 50 or 60 years. The HVAC and how it gets put into buildings now, where it would not have been originally likely part of this building with its age. New code requirements, Americans with Disabilities Act, and requirements for wheelchair access, and they didn't put doors as wide as were required. Obviously the bathrooms are a lot smaller than they're required to be now. So a lot of challenges when you get into an older building.
Really saw the challenges for the front renovation when I was taking the blueprints around to different contractors, and how many of them were just completely scared away. They would look at it and go, absolutely not, or let me look at it, I'll get back to you, and then you don't hear from them, and then you call and they're like, yeah, I don't want to deal with everything that you have to deal with to work downtown. We only ended up with two quotes for the entire front renovation. The same thing with the lobby. We put those out for bid, and we got four or five different people that, like, we thought were good contractors for it. And again, I don't think we got one and a half responses of, yep, I'll do it, and maybe I'd be interested, but here's my issues. And since it's time sensitive, it's like, well, all right, that helps clarify what we're doing. We have to fit these projects in between the actual running of the theater and the shows.
And I buy off definitely that we have certain standards downtown that we need to, all of us, meet in order to preserve the quality of historic buildings, as well as consistency across all the buildings downtown.
The lobby renovation, more so than anything else, was sort of a facelift with the intent of trying to go back towards what the original lobby may have been. Originally, as you came into the door, there was a much higher ceiling, so we've tried to get some of that back. The intent to update, as well as to sort of pay homage to the original structure, bring a little bit of technology in. So we'll see some flat screens in there, so we won't have bulletin boards in place anymore. And really embracing technology in a way that we've not been able to do in the past.
During the recession, when we weren't able to do the renovation and we were doing all these tiny fixes, but important but tiny fixes that we could afford, during the floods, during the ceilings falling down, ceiling tiles falling down, all kinds of construction mess while patrons are coming in, you would think that any normal group of people would be frustrated or irritated at all this mess, or irritated that you can't move faster and forward in the direction that you want to. But this is why New Bern Civic Theater to me is so spectacular, is because during every trial of our journey here, it's a story, and we're either laughing about it or reminiscing about it or looking back and saying, this is the journey that we took, and this is the destination, and the results were worth every little heartache and trip in this journey that we've taken, which is actually befitting of New Bern Civic Theater, because that's what theater is about. It's about looking to the past learning about your present and using it as you look forward into the future. This is where stories are made. This is where you find humor in tragedy. Not once will I ever look back and think, wow, that wasn't worth it. That was hard. Because it makes where we are right now that much sweeter.